Hello and welcome to another quick guide with Mr. E. Today I thought of putting a tank guide together for the first four mythic bosses of Eternal Palace. Starting with Commander Savara, there isn't much change from normal and heroic. We tank the boss facing the wall and you should be able to comfortably solo soak crushing reverberation. The tank swap is really up to you, but we're looking for swaps around 4-5 stacks during overwhelming barrage. This gave us time to drop our pull on the outside and trigger our unstable mixture. Moving right along to the Blackwater Fish, I'd like to say nothing changes for tanks except for the slight increase of damage. As usual, tank swaps are around 9-10, however if you're off the off tank and you need a heal, just turn early. We finally get to start mixing things up with Radiance of Ashara. We split the raid into two groups, placing both tanks in one group and all meleeing the opposite side of the platform. This is so that melee don't get parried. During the add phase, two spawn this time, so one tank goes right and one tank goes left, and after the adds die, the tanks should meet up in the same group, and that's pretty much a rinse and repeat. Lady Ashvane was a doozy, and I mean, we finally dropped her this week, and hopefully with these quick tips, you can smash it as well. Our taunt swaps happen so that one tank always gets a bubble, and the other always gets the cutting coral mechanic. Due to this, you need to collect two stacks of Barnacle Bash instead of swapping every bash like in Heroic and Normal. Tanks should always keep the boss in the outer ring, and if possible, drop bashes back on coral affected ground. The only time we ever moved the boss into the center was during the second cutting coral mechanic, which would move Ashvane to the center so that all ranged DPS could still DPS while cutting the far corals. The final thing a tank has to worry about is the rippling wave soaks, and well, we use a third tank to focus soaking, and even at one point that third tank get battle res to do a quick final wave before dying. As the main and off tank though, we really only had one tank get 10 to 12 stacks, and this happens around the third boss shield where the fight starts to get pretty hectic. Here's a quick image of our rippling wave soak timings, which will hopefully give you a better understanding on how to manage waterlogged. As always, this has been Mr. Re. If you have any questions or comments, please feel free to mention it below. You've been the fans, I've been the voice. Come visit me at Twitch TV, Mr. Re, and please give me a follow and like.